They're all here tonight. Thank you very much and welcome to my campfire. I've got a nice old mallee root on there, so it'll go all night, no problems at all. I'm originally from the Mallee, you might know. That's northern Victoria, where they grow wheat. It's named after the mallee trees, of course, that grow from there all the way across to the Nullarbor Plain in South Australia. And they start again on the other side of the Nullarbor in West Australia. So there's mallee boys and mallee girls everywhere. And my dad used to grow wheat in that red sandy loam country. But unfortunately, the rabbits liked it as well. And they used to eat my dad's wheat, so it was pretty typical for a mallee boy like me to go out on a weekend with a shovel over my shoulder and my little sheepdog called Blackie. I called him Blackie because he was black. And you'd find this little mound, which is like a colony of rabbits, little sandy mound at all the different holes, and you'd fill all the holes except the main one. And then you'd dig all the way along the main one with the help of your dog. And you come across all the rabbits and you grab them by the hind legs and whack them behind the ears. Whack, 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 whack. Get out of there, Blackie. What are you doing? And then you'd cut them around here, around the wrists, around the ankles, across the backside, put your foot on their back legs and just go, pull the skin inside out, put a spring wire inside it, hang it up to dry. And I used to get about a halfpenny of skin. Which wasn't much even back then, but there was a hell of a lot of them. And it was so typical, really, to skin rabbits when I was a kid, that when Mum would undress the kids before they put them in the bath, this is my young brothers, she'd say, skin a bunny, and they'd put their arms up, and she'd go, and pull up, close them. Well, I've ripped and dug out burrows on a sandy bullock hill. Eradicating rabbits doesn't take a lot of skill, but a boy born in the Mallee doesn't find a mark to kill. No self-respecting farmer lets a rodent eat his weight. He'll shoot him and he'll skin him, dress him up to eat. But since the spread of Mixo, he's almost got off the beat. And I don't mind at all if you call me a Mallee boy. Well, little town dogs howl at the morning train, where a cocky makes a living on 12 inches of rain, where his woman provides and is rare to complain. And I still love the smell of that sandy soil. Some say it's dusty, some say it's gold, because it grows the sweetest fat lambs the market's ever sold. And I don't mind at all if you call me a Mallee boy. You can join in this bit. Opening day, when slickers bring their shotguns from miles away and shoot the life out of shags and swans that fly their way. Where a bloke grows as stocky as a Mallee bull, where they come from miles around to see the tractor pull, when the paddocks are clean and seeds all over full. And I don't mind at all if you call me a Mallee. I've ripped and dug out burrows on a sandy bullock hill. Eradicating rabbits doesn't take a lot of skill, but a boy born in the Mallee doesn't find a hard to kill. Still they'll never be as rare as a Guangdong tree. My grandma made some jam for my brothers and me. They're like the Mallee fowl you hardly ever see. But I don't mind at all if you call me a Mallee boy. By yourselves this time. Call me a man. Thank you. Well, we actually lived in the little Mallee town rather than being on the land. Lots of farmers still live in Quambatook, is the name of the place, because we had little bits of land all around that was in the middle. And Quambatook is actually an Aboriginal word meaning resting place beside a river. And it's actually the Ook part that means water. And there are other towns around with Ook on the end, like there's Kundrook on the Murray River. And there used to be a Chinkapook and a Ninninook and a Chasachook. I made that one up, actually. And I've finally written a song that you haven't heard yet about Quambatook. Funny enough, I tried it first in the UK last year, and I thought I'd better explain one of the lines to them. I mentioned bindi eyes, and I said, well, they're prickles in Australia, bindi eyes, folks. And I said, my dad used to call them three-corner jacks. They're really, really woody, sharp, big prickles, you know. Other people call them cat heads. And I said, if you stand on a cat head in England, it goes meow. But if you stand on a cat head in Australia with your thongs on, you go, oh! My little town hasn't disappeared yet. Quambatook, take a look, we'll never forget. Warm in the shade of a peppercorn tree. Yeah, dear little Quambatook, hometown to me. It's as flat as a tack in the old Mallee bush. Billy carts were useless, you needed a push. But we had a river you could ride on a drum, or dive off the bridge, get a leech on your bum. I've got it so small, but it was my world. Never enough daylight to play in a town where imagination ran wild. Why did we all move away? Why did we all move away? There's the old pub where Ike Ritchie sat, outside on the bench where he spluttered and spat. G'day, Mr. Ritchie. He did a craven, eh? A good place for a picnic with fruitcake and flask. Stepping real careful like walking on glass. Yeah, watch out for bindi eyes when you sit on the grass. Cause oh God, it's so small, but it was my world. Never enough daylight to play in a town where imagination ran wild. Why did we all move away? Why did we all move away? Peaches and almonds and black muscatel, and a big mob of chooks with a rooster from hell. He'd crow before sunup to let the hens know that his cock-a-doodle was ready to go. So the town of my dreaming you can't take away. I wish all my neighbours were still there today. Or are they just angels in my fantasy, leaning on their fences and smiling at me? Oh God, it's so small, but it was my world. Never enough daylight to play in a town where imagination ran wild. Why did we all move away? Why did we all move away? Why did we all Thank you. Well, I had to mention chooks, because because I had chooks. I was the firstborn in the family of the five boys, and I ended up getting to look after the chook guard. And I sort of had chooks right up till I was about 23 when I went into this business. So I'm very fond of chooks. I just love the way you can feed them all this rubbish, all the scraps out of the kitchen and that, and out pops breakfast out the other end. Beautifully shaped. Don't like it though when they've got the rooster's DNA in them. No. And they always let you know when they've laid an egg, the hens, they're funny like that. They go, and the rooster walks up and goes, big egg! You've heard that, haven't you? Anyway, I got sick of the rooster. I couldn't see why we need to have a rooster. So we decided to have him for Christmas one year. So I had the job of taking him out to the wood heap and putting his head on the chop block and and he still ran around the bloody yard. And the head's lying on the chopping block going, you didn't expect that, did you? But the best thing about Quambatook for me was that it was a very musical town when it was a thriving little town. Like most of those little towns now, they've got smaller and smaller because of the bitumen roads and the bigger towns around. But when it was thriving, as I said, they had a lot of music. Every second person seemed to be able to play harmonica, and the local band was all wheat farmers. My dad played banjo, my uncle played fiddle. The old fellow on the drums looked like he was still on the tractor.
Five foot 2, her eyes are blue, kitchy, 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 coo. Has anybody seen my girl?
He's slipping around on the sawdust.
Whoa. Oh, I say, red, red, look red.
And I used to take over the banjo from my dad, and so if it wasn't for that, I guess I wouldn't be here tonight. And yeah, anyway, Dad, he's 83 now, Mum's 80 this year. And they had their voices trained years ago because they wanted to be able to join in the local productions of Gilbert and Sullivan. Can you imagine a little town like Quambatook putting on Gilbert and Sullivan? It was probably pretty ordinary, but we thought it was fantastic, you know. And they still, they're in Moree now, and they still sing together. I was talking to Mum the other day, and she said, hey, we're going down to the old people's home to sing them a song tomorrow. And I said, Mum, I've written a song about Dad. And she wasn't all that impressed. She said, oh, it'll be me next. It goes without saying, myself and my dad, how we love each other and always glad just to be together going up the road. And I speak for my brothers, I'm sure of that. I love the smell of his dusty hat, with the diesel and sweat and the smell of dogs, and the cracked old hands from all that work, the bandy legs and the rolled up shirt, the snort and the spit on fallowed ground. And it goes without saying, he's proud of us, didn't spell it out or make much fuss, just whistled along and showed us the ropes. And I speak for my brothers, that's for sure, if we ask for it, he gave what for, not a hard man, just as good as they get. With the cracked old hands from all that work, the bandy legs and the rolled up shirt, the snort and the spit on fallowed ground. It goes without saying, my old man was born of the soil, no particular plan, just bent on doing the right thing. He still toes the dirt and predicts the rain, and I'm sure if he had his life again, he'd be on a tractor singing a song. With the cracked old hands from all that work, the bandy legs and the rolled up shirt, the snort and the spit on fallowed ground. Gonna be hard. when he's not around. Thank you. Well, Dad wasn't a tough old fella at all. In fact, I'm sure the only time he smacked us is when Mum asked him to.
You wait till your father gets home.
But there was one day I definitely deserved a smack, I guess. Because we lived in the town, we all had mates our own age, you know, and I was wandering around town with two mates. Unusually, you had my little brother Willie following us around that day. His mates must have been doing something else, I don't know. And we didn't really want him hanging around because we found the wheat silo open. And in all the Mallee towns, those concrete wheat silos dominate absolutely because it's so flat and they're 120 foot tall. And we found the door open. At last, it was our chance to climb the silo. Of course, you weren't supposed to. That made it even more challenging. And I made Willie stay there. I said, no, you can't come up. No way, I'm not being responsible for you. So he's whinging and going on. So up we went, six little narrow ladders about this wide, no safety rails or anything like that. Little platform at the top of each one, covered in about 2 inches of wheat dust. What an adventure. Oh. We climbed all the way up the top and you've just got flat concrete surface up the top, with no rails again. And oh, I can see forever, all the way down the line to the next silo, and all the way down the line to the next silo. Oh, wow. And there's our little house down there. Oh, shit, there's the old man. Then we took out our bag of paper aeroplanes and went, whew. Oh, look at that. There's little Willie down there. So no need to tell you, next time we had a fight.
Anyway, Dad, Jock climbed the silo last Thursday.
So I got a belting for climbing the silo, and he got a belting for telling on his big brother. Oh, little towns were great, they really were. They were very safe, certainly back in those days. We seemed to have two ends of our town. Maybe it was one each side of the railway line or something. Because we always used to have a bonfire competition to see who had the biggest one on Guy Fawkes night. You know. Teary eyes at the window. Where did Mum and Dad go? Who is someone? Hurry up, come and get me. Jeez, I'm scared. The cat shot through. She saw the light and fled. Night was a real big deal when I was a little kid. They started letting them off after tea. I ran inside and hid. And all the dogs from everywhere were underneath me bed. Skyrockets singing, Catherine wheels spinning. What a flaming evening. Fire trucks were screaming. Smoky haze hanging round for days, and Grandma's ears were ringing. Every night after school, dragging bits of wood, boxes and branches and rotten old fences and mattresses were good. We even scrounged a vinyl lounge and anything we could. little Guy Fawkeses and letter boxes blown all out of shape. Light the wick and rack off quick and make the big escape. Cacking ourselves and ripping me shirt, scrambling through the gate. Skyrockets singing, Catherine wheels spinning. What a flaming eve. Fire trucks were screaming, smoky haze hanging round for days, and Grandma's ears were ringing. Then a house burned down on the edge of town. We all took off with Pa, when this thing whizzed across the road and nearly hit our car. A bang and spark lit up the park and everyone went, oh, crackin' night was a real big deal when I was a little kid. Seems like only yesterday, tucked away in bed. Dreams of schemes and double bunger, daring things we did. Thank you. I love it how little kids whistle out of tune, you know. I learned to whistle like that, especially because we had movies when the town was thriving. Like I said, down the end of our street was the little Mechanics Institute, Weatherboard Town Hall, and we had movies there about once a month. And if there was a scary movie on, I always walked home by myself, of course. It was very handy to have the whistle. The louder you whistle, the further the boogeymen stayed away. No tune, just... Then I started to whistle a bit of a tune. The digger stands at the end of the street, his rifle upside down. He died when a woman could walk alone anywhere in town. If she's not safe in years of peace, why did he go to war? What was the purpose? What was the glory? What was he fighting for? Yeah, sometimes this world worries me. Sometimes it makes me cry. Then one day more is one day closer to the day I die. And I think I'll leave it all behind. I've had enough to say. Go back to nature, live in the forest before they take it away. Was it to learn that I can't buy the peace I used to know when I was just a little boy 40 years ago? And I will keep on searching until the day I know the peace I knew as a little boy 40 years ago. Thank you. Well, I know my middle brother Robin would be proud that we're recording this on video. He passed away when he was only 47 in 99, and with cancer. He had a wonderful house on the Murray River at Moama, opposite Echuca, and he and his mate built this wonderful houseboat, and he absolutely adored the Murray River, and he used to go up and down that river, of course, in his houseboat a lot during that 6 months that he was fading away. And one day I went with him, and I tried to imagine how he must be feeling, you know, probably obviously thinking about his family and maybe Salisbury Street, where we were all together as boys in Quambatook. And he certainly would have been thinking about not seeing the Murray River anymore. Anyway, before I recorded this song, I could hear a fiddle in the production. So naturally, I thought of my old mate, Pixie Jenkins. Would you welcome him on stage? Thank you. Well, Pixie and I go back a fair way, don't we, mate?
You don't tell them how long.
All right, no, I won't. We go back actually to another song about another wonderful river, and I actually met Pix in the studio when we recorded this one. Thank you. Another song that takes Pixie and I back is, it'll take a lot of you back too. This one's dedicated to those here tonight and at home who have been in love for a long time. And still loving it. Just imagine a chocolate milkshake with double malt. Coca-Cola spider and a big bag of hot chips at the Boomerang Cafe, where I first met you, with lipstick on your lips and vinegar on your chips. At the Boomerang Cafe, where I sat down beside you, do you remember, my darling? You thought I was a fool as I rolled a cigarette. You thought I was too old, but I bet you don't forget the Boomerang Cafe, where I first met you. You remember, darling? Was it long ago, or just the other day? You played with the sugar, and I didn't know what to say. Or was it just a daydream, I'll never run again? Memories with you. All I could see was your brown eyes that would change the world for me. And the Boomerang Cafe changed the world for you. Do you remember, my darling? I recall it was raining, the heavens tore apart. Was it just the lightning and thunder in my heart? At the Boomerang Cafe, where I first met you, you remember, my darling? Thank you. Well, I didn't actually meet Mary Kay, my wife, in the Boomerang Cafe. I have to confess, I actually met her over by a tank stand. But I'm buggered if I could write a song about a tank stand. Mary Kay used to travel with me quite a bit, but after a while it was a bit like being with a truck driver, so she often meets me at the end of a tour now. And a few years back, after performing in West Australia, she flew to Perth and we both came back on the Indian Pacific, one of the longest train rides in the world. And we'd had a wonderful trip, you know, and we at night we were going over the end of the Nullarbor and the sun came up and we're in this, we're at the, like the Sydney end of the Nullarbor, just started to go through that red sand dune country where the mallee trees, little mallee trees grow, and that's where the habitat is for the wonderful Major Mitchell cockatoos, just west of Broken Hill really. And the cockies fly down to the railway line and they pick up the little hard paddy melons and they find the railway line very handy to crack them on. So they put them in their beaks and they go...
Bloody tough, this one, cocky.
And then they lift their wings and take off and they got all the beautiful colours of a flamingo, aren't they beautiful? And all the varieties of pink through their crests. They have to be my favourite cockatoo. Anyway, we heard the dinner, we heard the breakfast gong go off for the first session, so we were wide awake, so off we went. And there's not a lot of room in the dining car, so you always share the tables with other people, and that's part of the fun, of course, of being on the train. And this dearest lady with the white frizzy hair sat down with us, and we'd noticed her earlier having a great time on the train. Seemed to know everybody and all that. So I was quite surprised to see this happy soul when she started to tell us that she lost her husband about 6 months before. She nursed him for years, and he was 87 or something at the time. And she said she was so depressed when he died that she didn't get out of bed for 3 months. But the family finally did get her out of bed and said, look, why don't you go on the Indian Pacific? It's something you always wanted to do. It might help. Well, she'd been from Sydney to Perth and halfway back when we met her, and it had done the job. And over breakfast, she told us a lot about herself, which is a bit of a mistake when it comes to talking to me. Buried in her bedclothes, her old man has gone. Buried in her bedclothes, she couldn't face the music. Buried in her bedclothes, she's coming out today, going down the Great Southern Railway. Been with the same man for 60 of her life. Been right beside him, devoted wife. Been right beside him, whatever came along. Always been their own boss. Buried in her bedclothes, her old man has gone. Buried in her bedclothes, she couldn't face the music. Buried in her bedclothes, she's coming out today, going down the Great Southern Railway. Across the western plain, through the blue salt bush, riding in a train. Major Mitchell Cockie sitting on the track. The Indian Pacific is bringing her back. Started with a dairy, then they moved along. Bought a hotel, but things went wrong. Boarding house was okay, bought a taxi cab. Always been their own boss. Buried in her bedclothes, her old man has gone. Buried in her bedclothes, she couldn't face the music. Buried in her bedclothes, she's coming out today, going down the Great Southern Railway. Through the blue mountains, across the western plain, through the blue salt bush, riding in a train. Major Mitchell Cockie sitting on the track, the Indian Pacific is bringing her back. The Indian Pacific is bringing her back.
Thank you. Thank you, and would you thank Pixie for the moment?
Well, speaking of Mary Kay, you can see this wedding ring here. It won't come off. It's sort of welded on now. Mary Kay reckons if I take it off, it's got to go through my nose. Not sure why she, what she means by that. Now, the reason I mention it, it's pretty obvious, eh? But it didn't seem to make much difference when we were, the last time we were in performing not far from the centre of London. We had a night off, so Phil Matthews, my manager, and I decided to go and have a few Guinness at the local Irish pub. We like a Guinness, and we'd had a few. We were talking to the Aussie barmaid there, and we'd had enough. We thought we'd better get back while we could still see, okay? And we went through the swinging doors out on the street, and I look around, Phil's gone. Phil's gone. He's gone back to the loo. I'm standing on the street all by myself, and you won't believe this. Up pulls this brand new BMW. The passenger door flies open. I look in, and there's this young Jamaican fella with a real shiny head, shiny teeth, and he's patting the seat going. He was definitely looking at me. And I thought, geez, the Sheilas must be ugly around here. Then I sort of kind of worked it out and I thought, geez, I wonder how much I'd charge him. Then thank goodness Phil came through the swinging doors and I grabbed him by the arm and we walked down the street and had no more problems. This guitar only sings the way I play it. It's a part of me just like another arm. Started out as a little ukulele when I was just a boy on the farm. My fingers were too lazy for piano, but I could hold a tune pretty good. And I couldn't sing a song with a trombone, so I taught myself to play this piece of wood. But I know you are staying beside me. True lovers, we both feel the pain. And I'd throw this old box on the fire before I'd ever lose you again. Well, you never did like this old guitar, did you, darling? 'Cause the guitar takes your man away from you. One day I'll write a song for you, darling. It'll be the very best that I can do. Will it be a song about a wild wind with a thunderclap and flashes of blue? Or will it be a song about an angel? It'll never be as beautiful as you. Staying beside me, true lovers, we both feel the pain. And I'd throw this old box on the fire before I'd ever lose you again. This guitar only sings the way I play it. It's a part of me just like another arm. Started out as a little ukulele when I was just a boy on the farm. Now I am a man with a woman. The words I want to say won't come through. No matter where this guitar's gonna take us, it'll never be as beautiful as you.
Thank you. That's water. I wouldn't be here if I hadn't written my very first song, which happens to be Old Man Emu. It goes right back to... I didn't know I could write a song before I attempted it, and...
I was on the land at the time, up at Cropper Creek, north of Moree. And for years before that, I'd been a Roger Miller fan for one thing, and that was an influence. Yeah, if you hear the bit in Old Man Emu, well, that came from Roger's. He gave me confidence to do it because he was good at doing things with his mouth like that. And remember, Dang Me? Dang me, dang me, I ought to take a rope and hang me. I from the highest tree, woman, won't you weep for me? All that stuff, remember that? And then, I was also rapped when Rolf Harris, years before, started up with Tie Me Kangaroo Down. I was always liked the novelty stuff, and of course, he was so Australian, it was such a breath of fresh air. And I'm so proud that that Rolf has recorded Old Man Emu and Running on the Rock. And he had the wobble board, which is a fantastic Aussie invention. I guess he became across it because he used to paint on the boards and he wobbled it one day. Oh, must that works. So my answer to the wobble board was, and to his song, Tie Me Kangaroo Down, I had Old Man Emu's answer to that. But the wobble board, my wobble board was the jaw harp.
They squeak and squawk and try and talk. Why, me and them's like teeth and talk. But I don't know. Here come live and I'm telling you, we can run the band till I can get her. Well, a dingo came around one day. Too smart for him. Walked right up and kicked him in the shin. He come live and I'm telling you, we can run the pants of a hanger. Well, the last time I saw Old Man Emu, he was chasing a female he knew. As he shot past, I heard him say, she can't fly, but I'm telling you. She can't fly, but I'm telling you. She can run the pants till I can go. Well, there is a moral to this ditty. But a little da-da-da. Crush can sing, but he ain't pretty. But a little da-da-da. Duck can swim, but he can't sing. Nor can eagle on the wing. If you can't fly, but I'm telling you, he can run the pants. He said, it's true. Um, da, 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 da.
well sung.
Thank you. Here's one for the Bushies.
Galleries of pink glass, crystal nights with diamond stars, apricots preserved in jars, that's my home. Land of oceans in the sun, purple hazes, river gum, breaks your heart when rain won't come, it breaks your heart. Takes a harsh and cruel drought to sort the weaker saplings out. It makes room for stronger trees. Maybe that's what life's about. Winter's come, the hills are brown. Shops are closed, the blinds are down. Everybody's leaving town. Can't go on. South wind through veranda gores, winds and bangs the homestead doors. Our mother curses dusty floors and feels alone. Trucks and bulk bins filled with rust, boy leaves home to make a crust. A father's dreams reduced to dust, but he must go on. Tortured red guns unashamed, sunburnt country wisely named, chisel plowed and wire claimed, but never, never, never tamed. Swirls a paper high, same old news of further dry, of broken clouds just passing by. That's my home. Land of oceans in the sun, purple hazes, river gum, breaks your heart when rain won't come. It breaks your heart.
I sang that song because I'm often asked what is my favourite song that I've written. I guess that goes very close because it was the 65-66 drought north of Moree, Cropper Creek, that really broke our family up more than anything, you know, and it's still the worst drought in that area in recorded history. And there is only one of us left on the land now. I certainly found a better way to make a quid anyway. The other song, I guess, has to be in my top five is Cootamundra Wattle. Yeah. I suppose more than anything, because how it affects people that when I sing it to them. But I didn't do it the other night, and this dearest lady came up after the show, and she said, "You broke my heart." Because I didn't do Kudum Under Waddle. But I said, sometimes it breaks your heart when I do it, so I don't know. Don't go looking through that old camphor box, woman. You know those old things only make you cry. When you dream upon that little bunny rug, makes you think that life has passed you by. There are days when you wish the world would stop, woman. Then you know some wounds would never heal. But when I browse the early pages of the children, it's then I know exactly how you feel. Hey, it's July and the winter sun is shining, and the Kudum Under Wattle is my friend. All at once my childhood never left me, 'cause wattle blossoms bring it back again. It's Sunday and you should stop the worry, woman. Come out here and sit down in the sun. Can't you hear the magpies in the distance? Don't you feel the new day has begun? Can't you hear the bees making honey, woman, in the spotted gums where the bellbirds ring? You might grow old and bitter 'cause you missed it. You know some people never hear such things. Hey, it's July and the winter sun is shining, and the Kudum Under Wattle is my friend. For all at once my childhood never left me, 'cause wattle blossoms bring it back again. Don't buy the daily papers anymore, woman. Read all about what's going on in hell. They don't care to tell the world of kindness. Good news never made a paper sell. There's all the colours of the rainbow in the garden, woman, and symphonies of music in the sky. Heaven's all around us if you're looking. But how can you see it if you cry? Hey, it's July and the winter sun is shining, and the Kudum Under Wattle is my friend. For all at once my childhood never left me, 'cause wattle blossoms bring it back. Thank you. Well, Kudum Under Wattle, of course, was inspired by Mary Kay going through the old camphor box, finding the little booties of our daughters, and which always makes it teary because they're nearly 30 now. You know what mums are like. She reckoned that was the best time of her life. It'll never be the same as when she had those two little baby girls. And we did have a Kudum Under Wattle in our backyard at the time, and when I smell the blossoms of the wattle. I don't get hay fever, I'm lucky. It takes me back to when I was a kid, when Mum used to take us to this special spot outside Quambatook around July, August, when the wattles are in absolute celebration, and there's baronias and all sorts of wildflowers. So sort of, I guess my mum introduced me to that kind of stuff. I was around about 7 or 8 at the time, I guess, about when I learned to drive. Oh, it's great, you know, when you're on the land, all the kids learn to drive, you know. In fact, by the time I was 18, the old cop knew everybody in our town. And I learned up all my questions to get my license. I walked in, he said, "You know how to drive, don't you?" I said, "Yes." "Oh, okay." I got my semi-license the same way. Anyway, when I put this hat on, I look a bit like my dad. He had to teach 5 of us. Can you imagine what that was like?
Dad! Dad, where are you?
Where are you, son?
Dad. Oh, there. Hi.
What is it, mate?
Will you teach me? Oh. Will you teach me that?
Not that
teach
again.
Teach me to drive a tractor. Will you teach me? Will you teach me that? Teach me to drive the car. I know which one the crutch is, and I know which one's brake. So will you teach me? Will you teach me that? Teach me to drive the car.
You might know where the crutch is, son, but I don't know about the clutch. No way, son, it's too dangerous. You know what happened last time? I've just fixed all the gateposts on the farm. You flattened Grandpa's dunny, plowed up all his broad beans. Just stick to the horse and you'll do no harm. Son, it's too dangerous. It's too hard on me nerves. Still suffering from the time you hit the cow. She still won't let her milk down. I'll have to buy another one. Besides, I'm not in the mood for it now, and that's all there is to it. Listen, boy, you heard me. You're still too young, and blimey, you can't even see the road above the dash. You think you're in a bloody aeroplane, because all you see is blue sky. Only a matter of time before we crash. And besides, the car's too smelly from being in the river. Brakes go all the way down to the floor. And the tractor, remember, is tangled in all that barbed wire. Your mum and I can't take it anymore. You're sailing very close to the wind, boy.
Teach me to ride a tractor.
No way.
Teach me to ride.
Forget it, boy.
Teach me to ride.
we borrow Uncle Bruce's Mercedes? What about Mr. Fenton's Kenworth? I reckon I'd make a fantastic truck driver.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to drive me boot into your bum in a minute, boy.
Mum said you're not allowed to say bum, poo, wee or fart.
Right.
Oh, come on, Dad, let me right here. You should have always passed on
the birthday. Oh, gosh, well, you go on and on and on. You drive a bloke to drink, I'll tell you what. Oh, fair then.
Dad.
Go on and on, bloody on and on and on.
If you don't let me drive the car, I'm going to tell Mum where you hide your grog.
Hey, come here! Little mongrel. He doesn't make a bad little brat, does he, eh? It's all very well. You don't have to travel with him. Speaking of travelling, we want to take you up to Cape York, up through Cape York Peninsula, right to the top. It was just fantastic to go up there for the first time, you know. Quite a rough road. In fact, it's pretty rugged on the nuts and bolts, I can tell you. But, you know, when I was a kid, you know, like school kids, we had a little plastic map of Australia. You'd trace around it. And for the first time, I was right up that real little point, right up the very top. You remember that, Bix? Oh, that's right, you're a Tasmanian. We didn't have a Tassie map on ours.
We didn't have a map of the mainland on ours. Oh, he just kept tracing around that little map of Tassie.
I think we got the idea, mate. Anyway, Mary Kay swears she'll never go camping with me again after that trip up there. There's three couples went in three four-wheel drives, and it really, the corrugations are pretty horrible. And one place we camped, they reckon there were crocodiles. We didn't see any, but we read in the news a week later, exactly the same place, a bloke was lying asleep in his swag and he woke up with a crocodile lying on top of him, you know, keeping his lunch warm. Anyway, it's all in the song and the chorus is real easy to join in. It goes...
That's how you know you are, that's how you know you are, that's how you know you are on Cape York Peninsula. Give it a go. That's how you know you are, that's how you know you are, that's how you know you are on Cape York Peninsula.
Oh, that's good already. There's a warning in the travel book. Roads are rough and no Yankee chook, and the side tracks are just as crook. But you've come this far, so you take a look at a scary mountain with big black stones. Your axles crack and you rattle your bones. Find yourself stranded all alone, and you've got a bloody useless mobile phone.
That's how you know you are. That's how you know you are. That's how you know you are on Cape York Peninsula. Yeah. There's many strange tropical plants, big cathedrals built by ants. She finds a scorpion in her pants. Well, you've never seen a woman dance. Tossing her clothes all over the place. First the cottons, then the lace. Look at her go. Wow, what a pace. Come on, fellas. All about face. That's how you know you are. That's how you know you are. That's how you know you are on Cape
Cape York Peninsula by yourselves. That's how.
There you go.
Well, a kookaburra tries to laugh as a tin pot trailer falls in half. Your darling wife has had enough of using a bucket for a bath, but you're hardly even halfway there. Took you ages to prepare, in desperation to make it square, you promise her overseas somewhere. That's how you know you are, that's how you know you are, that's how you know you are on Cape York Peninsula. One more. Now there's crystal waters, moonlit sands, no old farts in caravans. They threw away their travel plans, they got no further than north of Cairns. No, you're better off to go by ship, cruise to the top, enjoy the trip, have a celebratory nip and kiss your husband on the tip. That's how you know you are, that's how you know you are, that's how you know you are on Cape York Peninsula by yourself. That's how you know you are, that's how you know you are, that's how you know you are. One more for Pix and Jono. Peninsula.
Oh, great.
You didn't understand the bit about the tip?
Oh, tip.
I think I'll leave it there. Well, it really is a thrill to climb down to the tip for the very first time, and there's a sign right on the edge of the water. It says, "You are now standing at the most northern point of the Australian continent." It's got a very low voice, that sign. And I had this silly idea of us taking photos of all the ladies giving their men a kiss on the tip. So I could take the photos home and show the family, "Look, oh, look, there's Sherry kissing Runt on the tip." Anyway, there was an older couple following us, you see, and lots of people waiting to have photos. And I could see you struggling, the old fella, so I said, "Give us your camera, mate, and we'll help you down, and I'll get a photo of your wife giving you a kiss on the tip." And he said, "Well, what's that, son?" "Oh, no, we're not into that sort of thing." No. True story. No sense of humour. Having a barbie by the river. With no one else around. A tropical honeymoon, knocking a 4X down. Standing in the water, eating a pumpkin scone. She was gone, and they were doing the crocodile roll. The woman and the reptile doing the crocodile roll in the middle of the river. Down came her husband with a gun and a carving knife to slaughter every crocodile for taking his darling wife.
You go-anders, you can't come round here eating out Queenslanders. Why, we'll turn you all into shoes.
It was in the news and they were doing the crocodile roll. The husband and the reptile doing the crocodile roll. In the middle of the river, down came his bloodhound. With mangy curly hair, picked up the scent, away he went, bum in the air. Then the dog got carried away and ran out on a log. Guess what? No more dog, and they were doing the crocodile roll. The canine and the reptile doing the crocodile roll.
about. The little swine drank the wine and really pigged it out. Then the crocodile chased him round. Then the little pig set up yours into another croc's jaws, and they were doing the crocodile roll. The porker and the reptile doing the crocodile roll. In the middle of the river, there's no moral to the story. Just a brand new dance. Grab your partner by the neck and swing your crocodile pants. Go for a fix. Picks her a rose, and his old heart still races. She's still the most beautiful girl that he's met. And you ask, is he happy? And you ask, is he happy? He's got wrinkles from smiling. Feels lucky and free, and he knows what it means to live here in the sunshine. He's got wrinkles. He walks with Amelia down to the store with a little cane basket for the bread and the daily sun. Still hand in hand like babes in the meadows, and young faces turn. Love is so beautiful, it can be so deep. And a man is a king when he has his own princess. Bob wears no crown, no long flowing robe, but there in his mind he still rides on his black stallion. And you ask, is he happy? And you ask, is he happy? He's got wrinkles from smiling. Feels lucky and free, and he knows what it means to live here in the sunshine. He's got wrinkles. Cold winter came, and Bob was alone. His beautiful princess had flown with the angels. He faded so quickly, the man became old. The wandering Jew
soon covered the roses. First just a cane, then a strong stick for walking, then just a chair with a grey old man dying. All that he lived for was always beside him. So Bob left in peace to join his lady. And you ask, is he happy? And you ask, is he happy? He had wrinkles from smiling. He felt lucky and free, and he knew what it meant to live here in the sunshine. He had
thank you. Okay, let's go out into the outback now.
The faces in the photograph are faded, and I can't believe he looks so much like me. For it's been 10 years today since I left for old Cork Station, saying I won't be back till the droving's done. For the rain never falls on the dusty diamantina, and a drover finds it hard to change his mind. For the years are surely gone like the drays from old Cork Station, I won't be back till the droving's done. Well, it seems like the sun comes up each morning, sets me up, then takes it all away. For the dreaming by the light of the campfire at night ends with the burning by the day. For the rain never falls dusty diamantina, and a driver finds it hard to change his mind. For the years are surely gone like the drays from old Cork Station, and I won't be back till the droving's done. Sometimes I think I'll settle back in Sydney, but it's been so long it's hard to change my mind. For the cattle trail goes on and the fences roll forever, and I won't be back till the droving's done. For the rain never falls on the dusty diamantina, and a driver finds it hard to change his mind. For the years are surely gone like the drays from old Cork Station, and I won't be back till the droving's done. For the rain never falls on the dusty diamantina, and a driver finds it hard to change his mind. For the years are surely gone like the drays from old Cork Station, and I won't be back till the droving's done.
Thank you. All right, did you bring the wobble board, Bix? Well, We're going to head up now to Darwin and Alice, all those places further north, further inland. I wrote a song years ago when I realised there was a lot of towns up there named after women. So see how many towns or how many ladies' names you can count in this song. It's called Amazing Day. I'll see you later, man. I'm heading up to Darwin, gonna say kakadu, gonna take my woman. I haven't been through there since Cyclone Tracy, and it should be an amazing day. I'll see you later, mate. I'm gone by the Isa, gonna say g'day to Catherine and Mary Kathleen. Last time through there I fell in love with Alice. She's probably forgotten, it's been too long. Ribbity-ba-doop-da, 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 ribbity-ba-doop-da. I'll see you later, mate. I'm gonna chase a buffalo, gonna see a jabiroo. Dancing on the water, gonna catch a barramundi. Up the south alligator with an Asian aborigine in a long steel boat. I'll see you later, mate. I'm gonna paint a picture like a black cockatoo. Away above the fire, they say it's in your trapo before the wet season, but I gotta see the light show before it comes down. Woo! Here I haven't been through there since Cyclone Tracy, and it should be an amazing day. Thanks, Rolf Ett. Did you count how many ladies in that song? Seven, you're right. You said, some people say six because they missed Ruby. Ruby doop doop da. All right. That's got us to Alice Springs. Around the campfire. Where I met Jim Hayes and his three sons around the stock camp at Onundulia Station, which is east of Alice Springs, where the McDonnell Ranges and Ghost Gums and Spinifex, everywhere you point the camera, you've got a wonderful shot, postcard. And the 600 square mile of country there. I was talking to Jim, and old Jim, I called him until I realised he was the same age as me. I was pleased to see his three boys had come home, because out of the five boys in our family, there's only one still on the land. Peter, he's up there growing wheat between Moree and Gundawindi. But Jim said to me there was one stage when things were very tight. He sent the three boys off to go and learn something else as a bit of a backstop. And he said, if you still feel like coming back to the station after that, fair enough. Well, here they all were with young families. And it was pretty obvious from what they'd learnt that they had no intention of staying away from Undulia. I'm into cattle. Father was too, from great great grandfather all the way through, and we've never been guilty of wasting daylight sticking to Hereford's, and it's been all right. Prepared for the lean times and saved for a drought,
you can't always plan how the future turns out. Life's getting harder to make what we need, with low cattle prices and more mouths to feed. Oh, six generations where camels run free. I hope I am never too blind to see. How fortunate, how proud can an old fella be? Three sons in their swags round the stock camp with me. I sent the boys off to school to see Adelaide. How other folks live, get a job, learn a trade. Couldn't keep them away, 'cause their hearts are still here. My butcher, my welder, my diesel engineer. Oh, six generations where camels run free. I hope I am never too blind to see. How fortunate, how proud can an old fella be? Three sons in their swags round the stock camp with me. And I come in for dinner, the sun hits the range. In a matter of seconds, the colours all change. From gold down to violet, the soul has been burned. And I understand fully why they have returned. Yes, I'm into cattle, my father was too. Great-great-grandfather all the way through. And we scarcely have wasted an hour of daylight. We work hard, we play hard, and we sleep well at night. Oh, six generations where camels run free. I hope I am never too blind to see. How proud can an old fella be? Three sons in their swags round the stock camp with me. Three sons in their swags round the campfire with me.
Thank you very much. Flies are really sticky out there. They try to crawl up your eyes and up your nostrils, and they won't go. You know, they're more like ants. They stick to the canvas on your ute and your head off, going flat out, and you get your your destination miles away, and they look at each other and say, "Where the bloody hell are we now?" So we've arrived at Hermannsburg now. This is on the other side of Alice Springs, where the Western Arana mob occupy their land. And I got a phone call from a fellow from there. His name is actually Warren H. Williams. He rang me with the idea that I might like to record a duet with him using my song, Raining on the Rock. Well, I was delighted with the idea, and even more delighted when I found out he is Albert Namajira's great nephew. And I believe that Albert, with his wonderful paintings, really showed us the colours of the centre before we saw them with our own eyes. Now, early in the last century, pastoralists hunted the Western Arana mob off their country into the Hermannsburg mission. And it was there that they were, well, their stories, their ancient stories and their ancient songs were outlawed as being unchristian and evil and all that sort of stuff, you know. But for thousands of years, through special elders, stones have been handed down, and these stones contain secrets of the tribal history, and they still exist. Now, before I introduce Warren, I want to do a new song for you that virtually tells me how I feel about Warren and his tribal history.
Mm-hmm.
take me from my land, you leave me with no soul. I am like a tree. Everything I am is rooted in the soil, or I am just a stick to burn. I see you, my brother, in your desert shining, with your hand of gentle welcome. You're looking for my sense of humor, I wonder how you do it, carrying a heavy load. I am proud to know you, the keeper of the stones, elder of your tribe. The truth is turning slowly, I feel it in my bones, rising on a beautiful day. I see it in your knuckles, I see it in your eyes. You have been as low as you can go. Makes me happy, brother, to see how well you travel. You've risen from the ashes, yeah. And I am proud to know you, the keeper of the stones, elder of your tribe. The truth is turning slowly, I feel it in my bones, rising on a beautiful day. Soon you'll be a poppy, standing on your own. They'll try to bring you down when you're tall, but you have the power given in the stones. Your victory belongs to us all. And I am proud to know you, the keeper of the stones, elder of your tribe. Truth is turning slowly, I feel it in my bones, rising on a beautiful day. Here I am proud to know you, the keeper of the stones, elder of your tribe. The truth is turning slowly, I feel it in my bones, rising on a beautiful day.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome on stage the keeper of the stones, Warren H. Williams. Whoa, how was that? We got a song called A Thousand Feet that I wrote around the campfire out at Hermannsburg itself. And you can start it, hey?
It's not a hard place. It's a soft and gentle land. Gonna lay my bed on the soft and gentle sand. Hear old man time whisper in my ear. Thousand feet have been through here. Hear the desert wind play a lonely tune through the desert oak on a rusty June. Stay a while and it's all so clear. A thousand feet have been through here. Inca, Inca, Pichicala. Thank you.
It's a soft and gentle land. Now I lay my bed on the soft and gentle sand. Hear old man time whisper in my ear. A thousand feet have been through here. Take it slow, take a look around. All the signs are on the ground. Bird and snake and lizard and kangaroo. An ancient man has been here too. Hear the desert wind play a lonely tune. Through the desert oak on a rusty dune. Stay a while and it's all so clear. A thousand feet have been through here. Inca, Inca, Chicala. Inca, Inca, Chicala.
While Warren's detuning his guitar back up, it's probably out of tune from being in Alice Springs, mate.
Well, it's about 37 back over there, and it's 1 year. It's cold down here. it's such a big place, because like Truin Round, it's such a big place. And I just started wondering, you know, seeing all these beautiful places, it's in the same country. And do we realise that we're in the best country in the world? Yeah.
And we've got one of the best guitarists and songwriters in the world, and I'd like Warren to do one of his.
This song is called What a Place. I hope you like it.
Two, three, four.
Way out where the western starts to blow. And the green grass has turned to gold. Red dust is dancing on the plains, and a wedge-tailed circle's high, where the night is crystal clear, and the stars shine so the side, there's horses taken off, disturbed by a dingo's call. His call is loud and clear, like the howling of the wind. Here a man can say to himself, oh, what a place I'm in, where the night stars shine so bright. Here a man can say to himself, oh, what a place I'm in. Oh, what a place I'm in. Oh, what a place I'm in.
Well, folks, if you haven't seen Uluru, you owe it to yourself and your family to really show them what the spirit of this country really is about. There is something about the centre of the heart of this country that really gets to you, and I really feel like Uluru is the heart. If you look at the top of it, it is the shape of the top of a heart, and I imagine all the refs going down like a huge heart. And that's exactly how you feel when you're out there. We're going to take you out there now anyway.
Daisies and a beautiful desert rose. Where does their beauty come from? Heaven knows.
I could ask to wait to tell, but he's way too high. I wonder if he understands.
It's wonderful to fly.
It's raining on the rock. Beautiful. Proud to travel this big land as an aborigine. It's raining on the rock. What an almighty sight to see. I'm wishing and I'm dreaming that you were here.
Be described with a picture, the mesmerizing colors of the alders.
But if you land you off the rock,
Uluru is power. It's raining on the rock, in a beautiful country. How to travel this big land as an aborigine. It's raining on the rock. What an almighty sight to see. I'm wishing and I'm dreaming that you were here.
Warren H. Williams. He'll be back.
In the finest harbour in the world, in a cove they're calling Sydney, the Captain Governor Philip trimmed his sail. With shelter from the winds and the big Pacific Ocean, we landed in New South Wales. And you should see the parrots
all coloured in like rainbows, wallabies and screeching cockatoos. And a bird that won't stop laughing when he sees me getting a flopping, he wouldn't be laughing if he was in my shoes. You beat your drum, you drink your rum, you threaten me with hanging. Best ever go wear the chain around me ankle. But give it half a chance, I'd break and disappear in the grey gums and learn to live like a native in this land. Yeah, you beat your drum, you drink your rum, you threaten me with hanging. Best ever go wear the chain around me ankle. Now give it half a chance, I'd break and disappear in the grey gums and learn to live like a native in this land. And I can't feel those chains any longer, can you? I'm footloose and free. Can't see the sense in red, white and blue. Still Union Jack to me. We're drifting in the ocean alone now, like a beautiful ship at sea. And I can't feel those chains any longer. I love this big country. So I'll raise my glass to the diggers, jump like a kangaroo, stare them in the eye like an emu. I'll always be true blue. Have you ever spoken to a gum tree? What am I trying to say to you? Love this place half as much as I do, and you're a true blue too. In red, white and blue, still Union Jack to me. We're drifting in the ocean alone now, like a beautiful ship at sea. Now I can't feel those chains any longer. I love this big country. So I'll raise my glass to the diggers, jump like a kangaroo, stare them in the eye like an emu. I'll always be true blue. Have you ever spoken to a gum tree? What am I trying to say to you? Love this place half as much as I do, and you're a true blue too.
Thank you.
Be the same in Port Lincoln since they rolled the cameras there. Roll up and be a movie extra, take it lightly if you dare, and give the man a uniform, give the man a gun. He's your younger brother and he's your only son. This is Gallipoli. They could have been your mates, they could have been me. You can't blame a bloke who likes adventure. He saw the posters on the wall. See the world through the sights of a rifle. Grab your mates and go to war. And give the man a bayonet, give the man a hat. Land him on the beaches. 8,000 never came back. This is Gallipoli, and don't you forget, you are the diggers of the Anzac, the diggers of the Anzacs. They're bang in the middle of an ambush. The Johnny Turk was all around, sitting ducks they fell like nine pins, but the diggers held the ground. And men like Simpson upheld the spirit of the digger who gives a mate a hand. And in the end they showed the world
same in Port Lincoln since they made a movie there. Knock off the shearing and knock off the fishing, bring up the clippers and knock off the hair, and give the man a uniform, give the man a gun. He's your younger brother and he's your only son. This is Gallipoli, and don't you forget, you are the diggers of the Anzac, the diggers of the Anzac. This is Gallipoli, and don't you forget, you are the diggers of the Anzac. Yeah, this is
thank you. You know the diggers sang Waltzing Matilda in the trenches. They sang it at the Boer War. It's very much about the battle. It's about a wonderful nature of this country. How ridiculous that anyone would say it's got nothing to do with our culture. They reckon we're not going to sing it when the wallabies are on the ground, pig's ass.
Once a jolly swagman camped by a billabong under the shade of a coolabah tree, and he sang as he watched and waited till his billy boiled. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Down came a jumbuck to drink at the billabong. Up got the swaggy and grabbed him with glee, and he sang as he stowed that jumbuck in his tucker bag. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Sing it now. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. And he sang as he stowed that jumbuck in his tucker bag. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me.
Very good. Fellas by themselves, next chorus. Don't let me down, blokes.
Down came the squatter, mounted on his thoroughbred. Up came the troopers.
One, two, three.
Who's the jolly jumbuck you've got in your tucker bag? You'll come a waltzing Matilda.
Here we go, fellas.
Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come a waltzing Matilda.
Who's the jolly jumbuck?
Who's the jolly?
Ah, oh, wasn't that great, girls? Give them a round of applause. Thanks, fellas. Okay, girls, when you sing it strong for us, fellas, next chorus, it turns us on. After this verse,
I've got the swaggy and jumped into the billabong. You'll never catch me alive, said he. And his ghost may be heard as you pass by that billabong. You'll come a waltzing Matilda.
Here we go, girls.
Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come a waltzing Matilda.
And his ghost,
and his ghost may be heard as you pass by that billabong. You'll come a waltzing Matilda.
That was horny, girls. Thank you. Ah, oh, yes. What do you reckon, fellas?
All together now. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come a waltzing Matilda with me, and his ghost may be heard as
think of all the men that played, that took the knocks and made the grade, the legends that the game has made. I can't believe I'm here. I wear the gold with a sleeve of green. It makes me strong, it makes me keen, and I'll go forward like a steel machine till cracks in the foe appear. Here we go. Could it be a dream? My father's son, that's me. A solid chin, 'cause champions don't always win. They're known for coming back again, and we will make amends. Sing it up now. Could it be a dream? My father's son, that's me.
And of course, now the Wallabies are their underdogs. Well, that's a swaggy all over again, isn't it? And how about that, eh? George Gregan, eat your heart out. You've been great. Thank you, folks. Hey, true blue, don't say you've gone. Say you've knocked off for a smoker, and you'll be back later on. Hey, true blue. Hey, true blue. Give it to me straight, face to face. Are you really disappearing? Just another dying race. Hey, true blue. Here's where you sing. True blue. Is it me and you?
his tan and buy a mate. When he's in a fight, oh, will she be right? Show on the road, hey True Blue.
Hey True Blue, be feeding.
Is your heart still there? If they sell us out like sponge cake, do you really care?
Here's where you're really joining, right here.
True Blue. Is it me and you?
Is it me and you?
Mom and Dad?
Is it Mom and Dad?
Cockatoo?
Is it a cockatoo?
Stand by your mate.
Before I bring my good mates back, I will do a song that often gets requests. Once again, it's for the Bushies, who are nearly always struggling, eh, out there.
City girl is happy with her friends and family life, appreciates a wine with him at night. She tries to find the sparkle, she searches but it's gone. With lots of love she hopes he'll be alright. Her man has gone all quiet, he's not at ease. He doesn't feel at home, he's hard to please. He gets itchy feet, he's tired of noises in the street. He needs to walk for hours through the trees. You see, a bushman can't survive on city lights, opera, rock and roll, and hide of heights. His moon shines on the silver brigalo, shimmers down the inland river flow, out there where the yellow belly bites. He's working with his hands today on a building site. He can smell the cypress on the floor. It takes him to a sandy ridge out amongst the pines. No shearing, no ploughing,
His kelpie dog is tired and fast asleep. Sick of searching gardens for the sheep. His master doesn't whistle tunes. He's not in the mood. His love of open spaces runs too deep. Now a bushman can't survive on city lights. Opera, rock and roll, and hide of heights. His moon shines on the silver brigalow, shimmers down the inland river flow, out there where the yellow belly bites. He tries to please his woman, the lady of his life, standing at a party with a plate. Finds him on the balcony, staring at the moon. That old familiar face he can relate. His moon shines on the silver brigalow, shimmers down the inland river flow. Out there where the yellow belly bites.
Would you welcome my mates back on stage, Pixie Jenkins and Warren H. Williams. And glory to Australia.
Glory to Australia, down under they say we are. Southern land, glory to Australia, down under they say we are. Over the moon am I with you in the southern land. Don't want to let another day get old or miss the clouds when they turn to gold. I feel the sun creeping through my head. Come on, sleepy, get out of bed. Australia, down under they say we are. Over the moon am I with you in the southern land. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Once again, folks, thanks for being such a beautiful audience. We've had a lot of fun up here as well. And, well, gee, come and say good day afterwards or whatever. We've got a song that says goodbye to you. It's called Mates on the Road. On the road, one thing in mind, to leave you with a tear and a smile. There's nothing like a campfire to help you unwind. Gonna love you and leave you for a while. Tomorrow we'll be wooing another little town. We'll always keep it up, even when we're down. Mates on the road, happy to be born to play music till we die. Let's hear the Pixies! Mates on the road, enjoyed your company. You filled our hearts with courage to go on. Like a boomerang, we shall return with another story and song. Tomorrow we'll be wooing another little town. We'll always keep it up, even when we're down. Mates on the road, happy to be born to play music till we die. Let's hear for Warren H. On the road, happy to be born to play music till we die. So adios amigos, goodbye. Here I want on my other chin guy. Has it got Warren? I want on my other chin guy. See you later.
Glory to